popular leaker Digital Chat Station has revealed the battery capacities of the next iPhones. Now, it appears that the 5.4-inch iPhone 13 mini will pack a 2400mAh battery cell, which is still a good increase over iPhone 12 mini's 2227mAh battery. Like last year, the standard iPhone 13 and 13 Pro will be a similar size device and will have the exact same battery capacity. Now, these models will come with a 3095mAh batteries, which is also a good increase over the iPhone 12 and 12 Pro's 2815mAh batteries. Now, here's the thing, the iPhone 13 Pro Max will get the largest boost in the battery capacity, like humongous. The tipster says that the highest end model will feature a huge 4352mAh battery, a massive improvement over the iPhone 12 Pro Max's 3687mAh battery, which isn't at all anywhere a weak performer in terms of day-to-day battery life. And if you can't remember, back in March, analyst Minchiko said that a new design would provide space for larger batteries on the iPhone 13 series. And yes, we are here talking about few millimeters of space. But yeah, the bigger batteries are also expected to make the new phones slightly heavier than current models, definitely. It was also reported late last year that the iPhone 13 line will feature the soft board battery technology, which would allow Apple to use flexible circuit boards in place of regular printed ones. And this will supposedly help create more room to fit larger cells. Now, on top of all of this, there will be LTPO display technology with 120Hz refresh rate, but definitely on the Pro models. And all these iPhones will be powered by 5nm A14 Bionic, which will definitely be more efficient than the current A14 Bionic, which is also a 5nm chip though. So in terms of battery, the next iPhones, or more specifically, the iPhone 13 Pro Max will be a huge champion to beat. Now, according to South Korean's news outlet, The Elec, Samsung and LG have started production of the OLED panels for this year's iPhone 13 series. Now, Samsung is manufacturing the LTPO OLED panels with support for up to 120Hz refresh rate for the iPhone 13 Pro and Pro Max. Even though I haven't heard any rumors that saying that it will come with both the Pro models, maybe just the Pro Max. This refresh rate was rumored to be added in the iPhone 12 Pro Max, but Apple thought that a 120Hz screen on top of 5G connectivity would be a too big of a drain on the battery life, so no. With LTPO units, this won't be an issue. Last year's Galaxy Note 20 Ultra has this as well, and the S21 series features a more efficient version of the tech. If you don't know, the LTPO enables a screen to dynamically change its refresh rate from 120Hz to as low as 10Hz. Now, the LTPO panel is also likely to finally bring always-on display to iPhones as well, which is always a good step. Now, LG on the other hand is manufacturing the conventional low-temperature polycrystalline silicons, the LTPS TFT OLED panels for the iPhone 13 mini and the iPhone 13. These models are not expected to support any high refresh rate, so yeah, there will be 60Hz. The report also points out that the OLED production for the iPhone 13 series started a month earlier than last year. And talking about the numbers, Samsung will manufacture 80 million display units for the new iPhones, and LG on the other hand is expected to supply 30 million panels. Now, as per a recent report, the A15 Bionic that will power the iPhone 13 range has also entered production. The new models will allegedly feature a slightly updated design with smaller notch and bigger camera models, definitely bigger sensors, and in-display Touch ID, which is cool. Now, Face ID will still be there, so if you're asking about that. And if you guys want to have this kind of tech news faster than ever, then check out my website joindavid.com, link down below. So yeah, that's about it. If you guys want to see more episodes like this, please hit the like button, please do subscribe or watch my other videos. Bye and take care.